Hello, my name is Ben Morss. I'm a developer advocate for the AMP project. My job is to help make it easier to make great websites for everyone. Today, let's talk about how AMP can guide you down the road to a great page experience. We'll talk about using AMP in a way people don't always consider to make better web pages for users. Shocking, right? But people often say they use AMP to get better SEO. Now, Google Search has announced they're in the process of making two changes that will change this conversation. First, although AMP is not a ranking factor in Google Search, soon something called Page Experience will be. Second, right now the top stories carousel is reserved for valid AMP pages, but soon the AMP requirement will be removed. Instead, the top stories carousel will be open to any page, but Page Experience will be a ranking factor. So, what is this Page Experience thing? Let's talk about that. But before we do, I want to just note that over in AMP land, we're pretty excited about these upcoming changes in Google Search, because AMP was created to make it easier for everyone to make fast, stable sites for all users. Finally, AMP will be just that, a nice option to make great web pages. AMP was made to create excellent user experiences. Page Experience is a set of criteria that measure great user experiences. That's why we think AMP is a fine way to start you down the road to page experience. Let's see why. When we say page experience, what do we mean? At the center of page experience is a concept called Core Web Vitals. Core Web Vitals is simply three metrics measured from real-world user data drawn from the Chrome User Experience Report. There's largest Contentful Paint to measure how quickly content appears on the screen. There is first input delay for the time between when elements display and when they're ready for user interactions. Finally, there's cumulative layout shift, which measures how much page elements move around during page load, potentially distracting the user. Let's look at each of these in detail. First, largest Contentful Paint. This is a new and straightforward way of measuring page speed, how long it takes for content to load and display. Of course, there's lots of ways to measure speed. First, Contentful Paint is a popular metric, and largest Contentful Paint builds on its success. Speed index is a personal favorite, but it's pretty hard to explain. LCP is simple. How long does the largest element in the viewport take to appear? This element could be a hero image, a block of text, or something else. It's when users will perceive that a large and meaningful part of the page has appeared. Ideally, this will appear within 2.5 seconds. Then there's first input delay, which measures how long a page takes to become responsive. It's not related to load time. It's the time between when a user first interacts with the page and when the browser responds. This reaction time can be slowed by long JavaScript tasks. And yet, you don't want your user to tap your menu button and then wait for it to open. First input delay should be less than 100 milliseconds. Finally, cumulative layout shift. This metric is newer. It's annoying when you're loading up a web page and you start reading something, and then suddenly that thing moves to make room for an image that's just loaded. Or even worse, a video ad. CLS measures how much elements move as the page displays. It multiplies the size of each element that moves with how far it moves, and it adds that up. Below 0.1 is considered good. To meet a Core Web Vitals goal, you want to pass it for at least 75% of your page loads. For more details about each metric and the science behind them, visit web.dev. There's a link for each on your screen. Remember, if you're a news publisher, page experience will be a ranking factor in the top stories carousel. More importantly, though, a recent study showed that when a site meets Core Web Vitals goals, users are 24% less likely to abandon page loads. So, how does the web do in these metrics? How do AMP web pages fare? To find out, we checked the Chrome User Experience Report, and at the time I'm giving this talk, 12% of non-AMP domains passed Core Web Vitals. For AMP domains, that figure was 60%. So AMP domains were 5 times more likely to pass than non-AMP. Why does AMP fare so much better? Well, just think about each metric. For largest Contentful Paint, valid AMP pages are built to have less JavaScript and less CSS. This helps content load quickly. For CSS, AMP enforces a 75K limit. For JavaScript, you'll have the AMP runtime, a small file for each component, and sometimes a little custom JavaScript all loaded asynchronously. Plus, AMP caches are quick, and they preload and pre-render content when possible. Soon we'll discuss how you can do much of what AMP caches do on your own server. For first input delay, well, less JavaScript means very little time between elements displaying and becoming interactive. It also helps that all JavaScript is loaded asynchronously. AMP can lazy load elements below the fold, so things you can't see yet won't delay things you can. And finally, AMP implements process chunking, so long tasks get split up and don't lock up your page. For cumulative layout shift, AMP's layout system involves declaring the size of every element in advance, so that when things load, they just pop into their spaces without making their neighbors move. Plus, AMP tends to require a user interaction before you can change what's on the page. So of course you can meet Core Web Vitals thresholds without using AMP, but AMP can make it much easier. Okay, now that we have defined Core Web Vitals, we can define page experience. Page experience is simply Core Web Vitals plus a set of existing Google search signals. Let's go through those. Safe browsing. Google search defines this as a site that doesn't contain malicious or deceptive content, like malware. With valid AMP, it's easy to notice if someone hacks your server and injects JavaScript onto your pages, since that would break validation. Mobile friendliness. Making a responsive site that's natural on mobile devices always takes some work, but AMP is here to help. Every AMP component is responsive, and AMP's layout system helps you make any element responsive. HTTPS. AMP can't buy you an SSL certificate, but valid AMP does require HTTPS for just about everything. Again, AMP offers to guide you along the path. Intrusive interstitials. AMP strongly encourages you not to block your content with pop-ups or full-page takeovers, and it disallows intrusive ads. AMP is trying to help. I said before that 60% of AMP domains pass Core Web Vitals. So what about the other 40%? What if you're using AMP and you aren't passing? The metric where AMP pages most commonly have trouble is largest contentful paint. Fundamentally, how quickly your page loads and displays content. Since AMP caches already do a lot to speed up web pages, we'll focus primarily on what you can do to improve speed on your origin. If your AMP page isn't fast enough, what do you do? First, as with any web page, you want to make sure you optimize your images, CSS, and JavaScript. Here's how. Just like any web page, AMP pages can suffer from too many large images. Compressing images and making sure images are sized appropriately for each device is as important as ever. Google's AMP cache will optimize your images when possible, but you can make them smaller yourself. Try a tool like squoosh.app. On your own server, you can always install page speed modules, which will perform the same image optimizations as Google's AMP cache. If your page is valid AMP, you're already following guidelines that ensure you have less CSS and less JavaScript than most web pages. Even though the JavaScript most AMP components use is pretty tiny, you can minimize that by making sure you don't use too many AMP components on a given page, or load up JavaScript for components you're not using. Google Chrome's code coverage tool shows that most pages use little of their CSS. Use this to find unused CSS and eliminate it. And try to include on each page only the CSS that page uses, instead of using the same CSS bundle site-wide. Of course, you should also be minifying your CSS. There's a lot more you can do. You can add a service worker. You should optimize your fonts. Check the link on your screen for a detailed guide. But let's focus now on what you can do specifically for AMP pages. This tool is indispensable for speeding up AMP pages on your origin, the AMP Optimizer. It performs some of the same transformations as an AMP cache, and it adds a few of its own. For example, in most cases, the optimizer can server-side render AMP layouts. By server-side render, I mean it will calculate AMP layouts like responsive or fixed height, apply the proper classes and inline styles, and serve that with your HTML. Why does that matter? Well, AMP comes with boilerplate CSS that hides your page until the AMP runtime loads and does this work. If it's all done server-side instead, the boilerplate can be removed, letting your content be shown immediately. Here's how that looks for a sample image. The optimizer calculates its layout, then it decorates the AMP image tag with the appropriate classes and the AMP sizer tag. Generally, we want to let AMP decide when to load images, but when your page has a hero image, a substantial image above the fold, we want to show that as soon as possible. Not only is this good for the user, but it directly speeds up largest contentful paint time. The AMP optimizer detects this hero image on your page. or you can use the data hero attribute to specify it explicitly. Then, if possible, the optimizer will not only calculate the layout and decorate the amp image tag, it will also add an image tag as a child of the amp image, so the browser can load the hero image before the amp runtime even starts up. To make the image load even sooner, it adds a link rel equals preload tag to ask the browser to preload the image. The amp optimizer can also minify your HTML and CSS and do so much more. It can make your site load twice as fast on your origin. If you're serving amp pages from your own domain, you need to try this. Finally, I'm excited to introduce to you a new tool called Pixie, the AMP Page Experience Guide. Give Pixie the URL of your AMP web page and it will test it against page experience criteria, give you results, and tell you how you can improve your scores. Here's how it works. Pixie sends your URL to the Page Speed Insights API to test Core Web Vitals. It runs the Search Console API to check mobile friendliness, and it runs the Safe Browsing API to make sure your URL hasn't gotten on Google's list of unsafe web pages, to ensure you haven't been hacked. Then you can check your performance on Core Web Vitals, field data from the Chrome User Experience Report, and lab data from tests just done. You see the results for other page experience criteria, and then you get suggestions for how you can improve. Are you using an AMP optimizer? Are you preloading the AMP runtime? Are you server-side rendering and preloading your hero image? That's Pixie. Give it a try. In this new and flexible world of AMP, there are a few ways that AMP can help guide you down the road to page experience. First, when you can, make valid AMP pages. AMP will make sure you stay on the page experience track. Besides, valid AMP pages still get found and served by AMP caches like Google's, which gives you a speed boost that's hard to match. For simpler pages, or for pages users get to from search, this approach is highly recommended. Or maybe you want to mostly build your site with AMP, but you can't follow all its rules. Maybe you just need the extra bit of JavaScript or that analytics package that doesn't support AMP. Well, that's fine too. Create invalid AMP pages. Your page won't get into AMP caches, but AMP can still help you meet your page experience and Core Web Vitals goals. Or maybe you've already got non-AMP web pages, you're having trouble meeting Web Vitals thresholds, but you don't want to adopt a new framework. In that case, you like Bento AMP. What's Bento AMP? The team is rewriting each AMP component so it can work without the AMP runtime. Soon, you'll be able to use any AMP component on non-AMP web pages. So you can try AMP in your existing pages, gradually replacing slower, heavier JavaScript with lightweight AMP components. What if you're using WordPress? The official AMP WordPress plugin smooths the way toward converting your WordPress site or certain pages on your site to AMP. That's it. If you're already using AMP, I hope I've given you some ways to help you pass Core Web Vitals and page experience criteria. If you're not using AMP, I hope you've now got a way to gently let AMP into your life, so AMP can guide you and your users down the road to page experience. Thanks a lot.